I used to classify the Molasson Saga as war fantasy. I don't know if that subgenre exists, but whatever, now it does. And the reason is simple. The whole plot revolves around the war, and war is a very common element in this genre. An epic final battle is always expected at the end that serves as a closing for the entire journey we have made with our favorite characters. Whether it is a satisfactory ending or not, that's another thing, and I'm not gonna talk about that aspect. At least not now. Today I want to talk about a group of characters that stand out in the saga for the personality they show up, the presence they impose, and the laughs they cause just by listening to an exchange between two or more of the same group, the Sappers. I am not a scholar in war history, but I can tell you one thing. A Sapper is a hard-working soldier, one that is in charge of building bridges, trenches, wells, latrines, and all that stuff. In Molasson, they take care of that and more, and that extra is what gives them their own personality. Sappers are the best group you can find in every Molasson book. Foul-mouthed, grumpy, morose. They can screw you up 5 times just before you touch the ground. And don't you ever think about touch one of his precious grenades, or you'll want to blow it up before a Sapper spots you. A little bit crazy in their craft, the Sappers are the most important soldiers among the Molasson ranks. You can have the best infantry, the best cavalry, or the most experienced hike fist, but if you don't have someone to dig a latrine for you, good luck looking for a place to shit. This is one of the most basic things a Sapper can be ordered to do: digging. The Molasson Empire did not conquer so many territories just because it had a large army. After warring against the Morrant, the Empire managed to forge an alliance with the Black Morrant, specials for possessing alchemical knowledge that allowed them to invent weapons that turns the tide of the coming battles. The Cussers. Visualize a Cusser as a grenade. In our world, grenades already exist for hundreds of years, and I do not remember a fantasy book that has implemented them. Well, it is not that I have read the Library of Alexandria of Epic Fantasy, you know? But here in the Molasson Saga, the Cussers are an element very typical of the Sappers, because they are trained in its manipulation, to the point that many people, including the Sappers themselves, consider their work as an art to be mastered. Hence, you must have big and gigantic balls to manipulate a Cusser and not explode into pieces. And you will say, yeah, those are grenades, what are you talking about? Well, just so you know, the Morrants developed these destructive weapons to be thrown from the air while they flew riding their giant dragonflies. And did you think that was going to be an impediment to the Molasson Sappers? Ha! Huh. How ignorant. Special crossbows to launch the Cussers and pray for them to be a good design. Balls with an alchemical mixture on the tip, capable of destroying a fortress, or if you have the guts, just grab the Cusser with your dirty shit hands and throw it far away. These are not simple balls, the ones Sappers have, and those that they throw in the air. It has its science. The alchemical components are wrapped in a thin shell, similar to an egg, surrounded by a layer of clay, and at one of its ends it has a cap with an acid that you have to push like a button. The acid eats away the clay below the shell, and once it comes in contact with the mixture, you better have thrown that damn egg right away and run as fast as you can from Hisar to Aren. But why do I say that Sappers are very important? Simple. They have the ability, if they want, to blow everything to hell with a couple of Cussers well thrown. Also, they are not always determined to destroy everything. They also fulfill assistance tasks. Here I have some examples. In the city of Pale, they had planned to mine all the walls, so that the second army will get in fully into the city and finish a siege that had been going on for quite some time. But all went to hell when something blew up the tunnels they were in, burying hundreds of soldiers underground. The Sappers were very important, to saving the largest number of buried comrades. Later on in Darujistan, they were in charge of manipulating the explosive that they hid in the street, so that if everything go to hell, they will blow up a part of the city. Although the Malassan later discovered the gas pipes, and knowing that, if an explosive almost destroyed an entire mansion, they didn't want to think what so many mines scattered around the streets of Darujistan will do. Although I am sure there were some eager to detonate the third explosive. I see them very capable of doing it. It will be an insult to say that they are a comic relief in times of stress. They are not just clowns who stand there talking two or three harsh and shocking sentences so that we can laugh. Absolutely not. They are there to work, and the idea of risking their lives with each explosive they throw away was driving them a little mad. Reserved and prone to send to hell those who wants to tell them what to do and how to do it, regardless of gender or rank. But I will not deny that I laugh a lot with these hood damn bastards. They deserve to be worshipped as gods, devils and angels all at the same time, each and every one of these bastards. Just like Coltan did, who after surviving one of the bloodiest skirmishes that the 7th Army could receive in its journey through 7 cities, and thanks to the invaluable assistance of the sappers, the Fist chose who he knows was the most courageous sapper of all and promote him to sergeant, only to find out that this guy was the elusive captain of the engineers. Yes, they are good people. Organized in a chaos that for us is chaos, but for them, well, never question their actions if you don't want to run away as if Hood itself wants to grab your ass. They are not cowards who flee before a greater evil. Until the end, they accompanied Coltan, where each one was killed defending their commander. There will be soldiers, heavy infantry, weakened horsemen, mortal swords, fierce swords, abode wounds, whatever you want. But no one can match the tenacity, courage, and bravery as the Malassan sappers. If you don't believe what I'm saying, just ask Silcha's Ruin.